This is probably the most user-friendly and the most flexible encryption software in Linux. Let's have a look how to use it. Hello everyone, it's Irish Linux User, helping you to install, configure and use Linux. In some of my previous videos, I have shown how to encrypt a hard drive in Linux with a command line. But some of you complained that this was a method from the 90s. So in this video, I will show you how to make an encryption in Linux with a beautiful graphical program. So this program is called Veracrypt. And if you used encryption on Linux before, you probably know the program through a crypt. But it is not secure anymore, and it is not developed anymore. So Veracrypt is an alternative program which is actually based on TrueEncrypt. So let's first install it. You go to Downloads, and you download the version you want to use. Actually, it is available for different platforms. You can also use it on Windows, and on macOS, and on Linux, and even on Raspberry Pi. So let's download it. After we have downloaded it, you need to extract the archive. So I go to Downloads, right click here, and extract here. When the extraction is done, you can open terminal here. So I go to my terminal, and I navigate to my Downloads folder. And then I enter Veracrypt folder. So here are the files we have extracted, and here you have choice between the command line interface and the graphical user interface. So we are primarily interested in graphical interface, and I assume that most of my viewers use 64-bit system. If you are using 32-bit system, you can use this installer. So what you need to do, you first type sudo, because you need administrative privileges to install this program, and then you type the name of the program, starting with ./, and the name of the program. Enter your password. Here you select option 1. Then you can press space to scroll through the license. And in the end, you need to type yes, that you agree with this license. So the program is installed. If you want to uninstall it, you can just run this command. I will show you at the end of the video. So I press enter, and the program is installed. So to run it, you can just type Veracrypt from your terminal. And the program has started. So Veracrypt provides several ways to make encryption. If you click on create a volume, you can see that you can just create an encrypted file container. You can just assume it's a virtual folder which is encrypted. And you can also encrypt the whole partition or the whole drive. Choose whatever you want. The principle is basically similar for the two options, so let's just create an encrypted container. Here I suggest you to use a standard Veracrypt volume, but if you are very paranoid, you can use hidden volume. So this is needed in case somebody found this encrypted volume in your system and they force you to reveal a password. I will go with a standard volume. Here you select where you want this encrypted volume to be located. Let's place it in Veracrypt folder and call it test volume. Click save. Veracrypt provides several ways to make encryption, so these are different encryption algorithms. I usually go with the default. This should be enough for most of the users, but if you want, you can read more information here. So I click next. Here you define the space of the container. So as you can see, I have 6 gigs free on my system, so I can create a volume up to 6 gigs, but I will create just 1 gig volume. Next. Here you define your password. This password will be used to decrypt this volume. I will use just simple password here, but usually you need to use a much longer password. If you want to be your encryption as secure as possible, you can also enable the PIM option. This means you just need to specify a specific number during the mounting process. You can read more about it at Veracrypt website. I usually don't use it. Using just one password is already quite secure, but if you want more security, I recommend you to use a key file. So let me show you how to use it. So you just need to create a key file. You just click generate random key file. Here you need to move your mouse as much as possible. to create some random numbers which will be stored in this key file, so you can move it until it is completely finished here, but for this video I will just stop here. In this field you type the name of the key file, and after that you just click generate and save this file. Again, I will place it here. So the key file has been successfully created. Now you can add it here. So we select this key file we have just created and you add it to your encryption profile. Now to unencrypt this volume, you will have to use the password, and in addition to this, you also need to use a key file. To make it even more secure, you can store key file, for example, on your USB drive. And to mount this encrypted volume, you need to connect your USB drive to your computer and provide this key file to unencrypt this volume. But be careful, because if you lose your key file, you won't be able to unencrypt this volume. So make sure you have a backup of this key file. It complains that my password is too short, but as I said before, it is a demonstration purpose, so my password is simple, but you need to use much longer password. In this field, you can define the file system you want to use. If you want to use this encrypted volume for different systems, I recommend you to use FAT file system. But if it is just on Linux, you can use X64 file system. Click Next. And you see you have the two options here, if you want to mount it on different volumes or you will just mount it on Linux. I will use it only on Linux. So I click Next. And here again, you need to generate some randomness here by moving your mouse as randomly as possible in this window. So you move it, the more you move it, the better encryption will be. So wait until this field is completely filled. But for this video, this is already enough. So I just click Format. So here you need to enter your administrative password. As you can see, Veracrypt encrypted volume has been successfully created. Now let's have a look at it. So after you created the encrypted volume, you need to mount it. So you select your encrypted volume by clicking here. This is the test volume we have just created. Next, you need to select where you want to mount it. Just select the first slot. If you have many encrypted volumes, you can mount them here. And click Mount. Here you enter the password you used for your encryption, and as you remember, we also used a key file, so you also need to specify the key file. And we add this key file. So now the encrypted volume should be mounted. And here you can see where it was mounted, so it is located in the folder Media, Veracrypt 1. You go to your file manager. The folder Media, and here is our encrypted volume. You can create a new folder here. As you can see, you can place any files here. After you finished placing your information here, you close it and you need to unmount it. If you have several devices that are mounted, you can just dismount them all. So now when it is unmounted, nobody can access your information without the password and a key file. After you finished working and you dismounted all the encrypted volumes, you just click Exit. If you don't want to have Veracrypt on your device anymore, you can remove it by running this command. You type sudo veracrypt and uninstall. Enter your password. So Veracrypt is uninstalled from your system. Veracrypt is a great program, not only because it has graphical interface, it is very powerful encryption tool, so I highly recommend you to use it. You can create an encrypted file container, you can encrypt a whole hard drive, or if you want to make your data very secure, you can also create a hidden encrypted volume or a hidden encrypted partition. Just explore all the possibilities, so you can make your data very secure. Thank you for watching!